numbness, three paths to unnumbing. Numbness is defined as depriving one of feeling or responsiveness. This deprivation or unresponsiveness is at the heart of the ecological crisis. It blocks our ability to feel and to act. In Conscient, episode 171, Kimberly Sky Richards, Department of Utopian Arts and Letters, Kimberly observes that
one that I talk about a lot or think a lot about is processes of unnumbing in relation often to the denials that we hold because of the magnitude of the crisis that we're facing and our complicities within it. And so being vulnerable, showing up with more of ourselves is absolutely part of that unnumbing. And it's hard work and it's uncomfortable work and it can feel so messy. But that, yeah, I think that for me, that's one of the roles that artists play within the polycrisis is supporting us through processes of unnumbing. Sometimes we might describe it as like reattuning of senses, the kind of listening, right, exercises and sound exercises that you offer would be part of that, right? And all of that, too, is about undermining the ways that we are taught mastery, to master ourselves, to not show emotions, to kind of disconnect our heads from our bodies so that we work more efficiently within the capitalist paradigm.
Yaya, aka Samziri, also mentions numbness. In episode 186, Yaya, aka Samziri, collective liberation as planetary right.
Art is something that really bypasses our walls, so to speak. Our numbness or our kind of like overstimulation that we might be experiencing in a world that is inundated with too much information.
And this leads me to think, and to question how artists can unnumb themselves. How can we retune our senses? How can we reconnect body and mind? How can we understimulate our surroundings? Now, I don't have any magic solutions to these questions, but I have discovered three possible paths to unnumbing for your consideration. First, in my previous A Calm Presence posting called Adjusting the Volume, I quote Nate Higgins in his The 20 Control Knobs for a Post-Growth Future. He observes that, what if we purposely turn the control knobs in our own lives to shift how we approach a post-growth future by embracing reality instead of unrealistic tech solutions, redirecting our focus towards deeper interconnection with community and local systems? Which control knobs might we turn to fill our hearts and lives with goodness, awe, and wonder? Unnumbing by adjustment. Two, in episode 22 of Conscient Podcast, Hildegard Westerkamp, Slowing Down Through Listening, Hildy observes that
to allow for time to pass without any action and without any solution and to just experience. And I think that slowdown is an absolute, if there is any chance to survive, I think that kind of slowing down through listening and meditation and through not doing so much, I think there's some hope in that.
Unnumbing by slowing down. Finally, a third path, Alan Urban in The Number One Reason I Became a Doomer, who observes that, I don't know how my life is going to end, but I'd rather go out helping other people than hurting people. As Michael Campy wrote, what if we did things not for points or rewards or recognition, but for the sheer joy that comes from making someone else happy for a moment? That's all that's left to us. He's right. We've already lost everything else. All we can do now is wait for the end and try to be a source of comfort and strength for those around us. And the conclusion of this third path is unnumbing by comforting. I want to thank Nate, Hildy, and Alan for quoting their work.
Yeah, I did.